until one day, legend has it, he was bathing in the river Purma, or Purna, one of those names of rivers, Purna, and a crocodile grabbed a hold of his foot and started to drag him down. And as he was going down for the last time, he begged his mother to allow him to become a sannyasin, which is, you know, to renounce life, worldly life, and to let him do this, just if it was only for a few moments of his life. And of course, what mother could really resist such a plea at this point? And so she gave her assent, and of course, the crocodile then conveniently let him go, thankfully for us. And a crocodile has never been found in the river Purna since that time. So, anyway, Shankara really revitalized and strengthened Hinduism at a time when there were so many different factions and everybody was arguing, and it was really chaos in India at those times. And so he is normally associated with the path of spiritual wisdom. He based his teachings on reviving the ancient texts and really developing more interest in those texts, the Upanishads, the Bhagavad Gita. He did beautiful commentaries on these texts. But he's also said to have